Hi folks, co-tutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to the next edition of Kotlin Tutorials. In the previous video, you have seen about setter and getters, how to create your own custom setter and getter. And before that, you have seen all about, say, constructor or parameterized constructor and init blocks. It is time to move further and explore a few more concepts. The one concept that I want to touch upon very briefly in this video is functions. Functions are nothing but reusable blocks of code that can be just invoked anywhere. If you have been doing programming, this is not something new to you. In Kotlin, a function looks pretty simple. To declare a function, you use the keyword fun and then the function name, opening and closing brackets. And this is the most simplest function that you could ever write. I can just write person dot the name of the function, and that will basically run the function and it will display me the name. So this is a pretty simple function, but there are quite a possibilities that can happen with a function. It can have parameters, it can have multiple parameters, it can return something from a function. So these are the some of the things that I'll be showing you how to do in this particular video. For example, right now this particular function is not returning anything. So instead of that, what if I want to return something from this particular function? That I can do by quote string, and then here I can say return first name and this dot last name. And here if I run this, it will just return the first name and last name as a concatenated string, but we need to display it. So what I have to do is I have to put this thing inside the println statement. So now if I run this, you will see that it will just print me Anil Deshpande. So you just saw a function returning something, and in the same way, function can have a parameter. So let me write a function, demo function, and to pass parameters, I can write param1 and I can make it of type string, and then param2 that could also be of type string. Inside that, probably I just want to display it, and I can invoke this particular function, that is person dot demo function, and I can pass the parameter 1 and 2. So how do I pass that? So let me call it as param1 and param2, and if I run this, you will see that it just displays param1 and param2. What if I want to modify param1? Let me take param1 and try to reassign with some new value. You will see that it is giving me a compile time error. Val cannot be reassigned. So that basically means whatever the arguments that you are passing to the function, they are treated as val parameters. So something that cannot be reassigned. If you want to do some modifications with whatever the parameters that you have received here, you have to assign it to a var and then change that. So what do I mean by that is, probably I will declare a temporary variable which is of type var and then assign param1, and then with temp I can do the changes and then try to display the temp1. But the parameter that I pass as argument to the functions, those cannot be modified at all. So this is something that you should be aware. So let me rework this. Now another part is, sometimes you may want to send some default values. So what do I mean by that? So you can see here that this particular function has got two parameters, param1 and param2. When I don't send any value to that particular param, I want it to take some default parameter. I can set the default value of param1 to some default value here, and if I run this, you can see that it still displays param1 and param2 because I am passing both the arguments. However, if I remove the param1 and send only param2, so this is how you send the named parameters, this particular value will be associated with the param2 and param1 will assume the default value that is being assigned here as a part of the function definition. So now if I run this, You will observe that it assumed some default value. But what if I want to send a value to param 1 and don't want to send any value to param 2? This will create a compile time error because this particular param 2 doesn't have any default value. But in case if you set the default value to param 2, once again you will see that the compilation error will go away and it will still work perfectly fine. Only the difference is now the param 2 will assume the default value because that is what we did here. I think another common question that some of you might be having is it possible to overload the functions? This is a concept that you might have seen in Java, where if the signature of the method is different, then can I use the same function name? You can see that here in this case, the signature of the function is one and the same. It is the same name, doesn't have parameter, and returns the same string value. So what if this thing returns an integer? Will it solve the problem? This will still not solve the problem because the signature doesn't mean the return type of the function. It actually means parameter list. However, if I make a param here, you can see that even though I have the function names as same, it will not create any issues. So basically what will happen is when I invoke the display person here without the arguments, it will run this particular function. So let me run this. However, if I pass a parameter, it will invoke the other function. So this is the function overloading concept. We will just stop now. The remaining concepts about functions we will explore in the next video. So stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.